In this lecture,
we will discuss about triangles. There are different aspects of triangles, the types of triangles, congruency of triangles, and a very important thing is similarity of triangles. So first we will see what is the meaning of similarity. Similarity, when we discuss, before that it comes congruency. When any two objects, any two shapes, geometrical shapes, when we compare and when we see the shape and the size, then if the shape and size both are same, then we can say the figures are congruent. But for similarity, if we observe any two line segments, since these are line segments, they are similar. But if we talk about its congruency, then the lengths of these two line segments should also be same or equal. Then only they will be congruent. But we can simply say this line segment L and M, or we can say AB and CD. Since these are line segments, that is why they are similar. But if I draw another line segment EF, whose length is also X, then we can say AB and EF are congruent. So if the figures are congruent, definitely they will be similar. But if the figures are similar, they may not be congruent. So all the congruent figures are similar, but all the similar figures may not be congruent. We will discuss more. Now suppose we take circles of different sizes. Like this. Definition of circle says that it is the locus of a point which has a constant distance from a fixed point. That fixed point is called the center, the constant distance is called the radius, and the locus. Locus means the path of this point B decides the circle. Similarly, in this case, if the constant distance, that I call it as a radius, that is Z, or here it is Y. Since these all are circles, so that is why they are similar. But all three are having different radii, that is why they are not congruent. But if I just draw another circle with the radius X, then these two circles will be congruent since their radii are equal. But these all are similar. Now if we take another figure, like ABCD is a square, and another square if I take bigger in size, since these two are squares, that is why they are similar, because their sides are not equal. So we can say in general, all the circles are similar, all the squares are similar, and all the rectangles are similar. But if we talk about a polygon, polygon means more than three sides figure. And if you are taking a polygon and another polygon of different size, then two things will matter: corresponding angles and corresponding sides. So it is important to see these two factors for any two polygons. Suppose I have taken a pentagon, means five-sided figure, and similarly I have taken another pentagon of this type. It is very important that the angles of this polygon are equal and the corresponding sides are in the same proportion, because all the pentagons cannot be or may not be similar. So for any polygon, two things are important, means two factors are important: the corresponding angles as well as the sides should be in the same proportion. So in general we can say that any two figures, if we have to compare, Then, if it is a polygon, then sides and angles. But we have to discuss about the triangles. So, to learn about the similarity in triangles, we will go to some axioms, we will go to some theorems, and we will see by those theorems we can compare the triangles and we can say whether they are similar or not. So, as we have seen in congruency, there were three elements, and according to those three elements, we had decided whether the triangles are congruent or not. So, similarly, here there are some criteria for the similarity of triangles also. So, we will see how can we discuss about the similarity of triangles. Now, before coming to the similarity of triangles, one more concept we will discuss. If there are two figures given and only the angles are equal, will they be similar or not? For example, if I take a square and a rectangle, what is common in these two? All the angles of square are of 90 degrees each. Similarly, I can say all the angles of rectangle are also of 90 degrees. So, only if I am taking the factor angles, then these two figures are not similar. So, only angles will not work of different shapes. So, what we have to discuss is, first of all, the shape, and with the shape also, if we are taking one factor with two figures having equal angles, then to the rectangle and square and a rectangle will not be similar, because only angles will not work. Or if I take a square and the sides of this square, suppose I say this is one unit, here it is one unit and one unit. And if I talk about this E, F, G, H is a rhombus with the sides two units. Means what we are discussing? The ratio of the corresponding sides. The ratio of the corresponding sides of these two figures will be 1:2. But will they be similar? No. So only angles will also not work. Only ratio of the corresponding sides, if it is equal, then also it will not work. So for polygons, more than three sides, angles as well as the sides. Angles should be equal and the corresponding sides should be in the same ratio, then only the polygons will be similar. Now we will discuss about the triangles. If we take any two triangles, for example, triangle ABC and triangle BQR. We have to discuss the similarity of triangles. So, for that it is important that two triangles which we are taking, their shapes should be same. Means, if you are taking two triangles, both are acute angle triangles, then two factors are there. One is, we have to discuss about the corresponding angles. And we have to see the corresponding sides. As we had seen earlier for the congruency, there are six elements of any triangle. Are all six important to discuss? Similarly, in the triangles also we will see all six elements are important to discuss for the similarity? No. So, there are some similarity criteria. So, for simple example, I have taken acute angle triangle and right angle triangle. Any acute angle triangle cannot be similar to a right angle triangle. So, what does it mean? It means if I take another acute angle triangle, suppose EFG, will these two be similar? No. So, what we have to see, we have to look for the criteria, and the criteria, first criteria is AAA. Means if a triangle's three angles are equal to the angles of another triangle, then only the triangles will be similar.
So if I take an acute angle triangle ABC and another acute angle triangle I have taken in such a way that angle A is equal to angle P and angle B is equal to angle Q and angle C is equal to angle R.
We can say if two angles are equal, automatically the third angle will be equal. But if we talk about the similarity criteria, normally we say it is AAA and AA is the corollary. Means a part of that. If two angles are equal, automatically the third angle will be equal. So if we are comparing two triangles and if we say their corresponding angles are equal, then the triangles will be similar so as their corresponding sides will be in the same ratio or proportion. Very important is the order and one-to-one correspondence. One-to-one correspondence means here A, vertex A is having one-to-one correspondence with P. Similarly, vertex B and vertex Q, vertex C and vertex R are in one-to-one correspondence. So, if the angles are equal, then the corresponding sides, when we write the order, and we have to be very clear that the order comes with the one-to-one correspondence only. Means when you are taking the order ABC, then you have to take the order PQR. So it is very important how do we write the order of the similar triangles. So we will write it as ABC. This is the sign for similarity. An inclined S. This was for congruency. And this is for similarity. Triangle ABC is similar to triangle PQR. Now, look at the sides. The sides will be AB will be having one-to-one correspondence with this PQ, BC with QR and AC with PR. Okay? So, if we are writing the proportionality means if you are writing the sides in the same proportion means what? We will write it as AB upon PQ is equal to BC upon QR is equal to AC upon PR. So these two factors, corresponding angles are equal, so the corresponding sides will be in the same proportion. Or, if the corresponding sides are in the same proportion, the triangles will be similar. So, this is different criteria. This criteria I have taken AAA. Means first I took, if the angles are equal, the triangles are similar. So, as the sides will be in the same proportion. The second criteria is, SSS means if all the three sides of one triangle, we take the ratio of the other one, means AB upon PQ, BC upon QR and AC upon PR are in the same ratio, then the triangles will be similar and so the corresponding angles will be equal. So what we have seen in two triangles, if all three angles are equal, the triangles will be similar, the corresponding sides will be proportional. And second, if the three sides of one triangle we are taking and three sides of another triangle means in this case we are comparing the sides. If the sides are in the same ratio, the triangles will be similar so as the corresponding angles will be equal. There is one more criteria that is called SAS. We have to be very careful when we talk about similarity because there are two basic differences. When we talk about the angles and when we talk about the sides, in case of congruency, the angles are equal means first point, if we are talking about congruency, then the angles are equal. When we talk about the similarity,
if we are talking about the similarity, then two, the angles are equal.
But if we talk about the sides, in case of congruency, the sides are also
equal.
But in case of similarity, the sides are proportional.
So, this is the basic difference. Proportional means they are in the same ratio.
So, we can say all the congruent figures are similar. But all the similar figures may not be congruent. So, the third criteria what I was talking about, that is SAS.
It means that if we take two triangles, ABC and PQR,
and if we take any two sides ratio,
suppose I have taken AB upon PQ is equal to BC upon QR.
When we are taking these two sides ratio, which is given equal, then the angle should be included.
It means angle B is equal to angle Q. Then we can say triangle ABC is similar to triangle PQR.
Here also we have compared the three elements. So, when we say two sides are in the ratio of two sides is equal, automatically after similarity, the rest of the elements means what? Rest of the elements are two angles left out. So, when the triangles are similar by some criteria, the left out elements will also be, angles will be equal and rest of the sides will be in the same ratio. So, when I am saying these two triangles are similar, then
angle A will be equal to angle P, angle C will be equal to angle R,
and other sides which are left out
means AC upon PR will also be equal to BC upon QR and also will be equal to AB upon PQ.
Means when the triangles are similar, the corresponding angles are equal and the corresponding sides are in the same ratio. But whatever we have taken except that, the remaining parts, we can also write about them according to this similarity. So what we have seen, there are three criteria. AAA, but AAA contains AA corollary. Okay, so AAA, or in other words, we can say only AA will also work because automatically the third angle will be equal by angle sum property. And second is when we are discussing about the all three sets of the sides are in the same ratio, the corresponding angles will be equal, the triangles will be similar, or if two sides ratio is equal and the included angle is also equal, ratio of sides equal and included angle equal, then we can say the triangles will be similar. Now we will discuss the basic proportionality theorem, which is based on similarity of triangles. Two triangles are similar when the corresponding angles are equal and the corresponding sides are in the same proportion. This theorem is taken by a mathematician Thales, and it is also known as basic proportionality theorem. So that we have to take in a triangle, means in a triangle we have to take one side and we have to draw a line parallel to that. And according to basic proportionality theorem, in a triangle ABC, the theorem says, if we draw a line parallel to one of the sides of the triangle, for example, I have taken this, there are different situations possible. It is not necessary that we have to take this line which is parallel to one of the sides, which is exactly meeting the midpoints of other two sides. The line can be drawn like this, or like this, or like this, or like this. Okay? One possibility is this. Or you can also take
parallel line to this also side. Or the third possibility is if we are taking this. So the theorem says if a line is drawn parallel to one of the sides. So here I have taken this DE is parallel to BC. As I said, there are different possibilities. Means you can consider this line parallel to this or this parallel to this. Means different situations are possible. Second, I have taken in this case BC in consideration, or in this case I have taken AC in consideration. So this is the line which is parallel to this. In this case I have taken AB as a line segment or the side of the triangle parallel line to this. So these all are the possibilities. We will take one possibility which says that if a line is drawn parallel to one of the sides of the triangle, then it divides the other two sides in the same proportion. This is the statement of Thales' theorem or basic proportionality theorem. So the very first thing in the theorem is the statement. When any theorem is famous by the name, it is very important to learn the statement also. So the statement of Thales or the basic proportionality theorem is, if a line is drawn parallel to one of the sides of the triangle, it divides the other two sides in the same proportion. So when this DE is drawn parallel to BC, the other two left out sides are AB and AC. It means this DE will divide these two sides in the same ratio. So for any theorem, first is the statement, which already I have given. When the statement is written, then we have to write symbolically on the basis of the statement what is given and what is to be proved. Then if there is any construction applicable over there, and the most important thing is the proof. So according to basic proportionality theorem, what is given to us? First we will discuss that. It is given that a triangle ABC in which DE is parallel to BC. This much is given. And what is to be proved? Proved is AD upon DB. Ratio is same, means the ratio of these two parts. So what is to be proved? This DE divides the other two sides in the same ratio. Same ratio means the left out parts are AD, DB, AE and EC. Actually these are called intercepts. AD upon DB is equal to AE upon EC. This has to be proved. Okay. Now this AD is part of triangle ADE. This DB is not part of any triangle. So for that we have to join this DB. Why? So that this DB will be part of this triangle DEB. Similarly, on this side, other side, AE and EC. AE is part of this triangle ADE. Okay. Now EC is not part of any triangle. So we will complete it by drawing this DC. So this is first construction. What have we drawn? We have drawn two line segments in such a way that this DB and EC, DB and EC are now the parts of two triangles. One construction we have done that. Now this AD, as I said, it's a part of this triangle ADE. We will apply here the formula area of triangle. Okay. So first case when ADE we are taking, AD is the base. So for writing the area of any triangle, we require its base and the height, corresponding height. So for this AD base, the corresponding height is this EN. So another construction, what we have done, we have dropped a perpendicular from this E on this AD. Okay. Now, similar case, when we are saying AE is the base, for this AE, we require its corresponding perpendicular or the height. So for that we will draw another perpendicular. This is DN.
So four line segments we have drawn that will go in the construction part according to our need. Okay. So construction is, first I have drawn DC and BE. So simply we can write, draw BE and DC. Then I have taken this one perpendicular here and the one over here. So that we will write in symbolic form. Draw EM perpendicular to either write AD or write AB, same thing. AD or AB. Similarly, this DN perpendicular. This DN is perpendicular to AE or AC, same thing. So now, what we have done? Four line segments and all four symbolically what we have written it now. What we have to prove? AD upon DB. AD is part of this triangle ADE. AE, right hand side, is part of the same triangle. But first case, AD is base, corresponding altitude is EM. Second case, AE is the base, corresponding altitude is DM. So one by one we will take the triangles and we will write the areas of those triangles. First case, AD and DB, AD, DB. Two triangles we will consider. Second part, AE and EC, two triangles we will consider and we will divide it and we will get what we require. So first let's take area of triangle ADE. Now, remember the need. So it will be clear in our mind what is our requirement. In triangle ADE, we require AD as the base. So half into AD into. For that AD, the corresponding altitude is, or the height is EM. Okay. Now, DB. DB. If you look at this triangle, DB is the base. For that base, you require the corresponding height or the altitude. It means that on this DB produced from this opposite vertex, this is the altitude. It means that this EM is altitude for this triangle ADE as well as for triangle DBE on producing this DB up to this. So for writing the area of triangle DBE, by taking BD as the base, the corresponding altitude will be EM only. Okay, why? Because if you notice this angle, it is more than 90 degrees. So the altitude will go outside the triangle on produced side. Okay. So we can write area of triangle DBE is equal to half of DB. And as I said, the same EM is the altitude for this corresponding base DB. Okay. Now, these are two statements. Now, right hand side, your requirement is AE. So again, the same triangle ADE we can consider. But in this case, the base will be AE. On this AE, the corresponding altitude is DN. So half into AE into this DN. Second is EC. Now, look at this triangle, this EC. When you are saying EC, so in this triangle, ECD. Okay? In this triangle, ECD. When we are saying this EC is the base, it means the altitude or the height of this triangle should come from this D. and that will come on the extended CE, that is DN. It means that this DN is height for this triangle ADE also, and for this triangle DEC also, because we have extended this side CE up to this and the altitude is meeting on the produced CE. So, area of triangle DEC will be half of EC into same DN, because on produced CE, this perpendicular or the height of the triangle we have considered. Now, these are four equations. What is our need? AD upon DB, AE upon EC. It means we will divide these two and we will divide these two and we will see what is our requirement. So, on dividing, we can number them. This is 1, 2, 3 and when we divide 1 and 2, 1 divided by 2. Left hand side, what we are getting? Area of triangle ADE upon area of triangle DBE is equal to half of AD into EM upon half of DB into EM. Ultimately, half of cancelled, EM, EM cancelled. AD upon DB. This we have got. Similarly, when we will divide these two, if we will divide these two, half will be cancelled, DN, DN will be cancelled. So, what are we going to get? Area of triangle ADE upon area of triangle DEC is equal to AE upon EC. So, that I am writing directly. Divided by 4. So, what are we going to get? Upon. I have directly cancelled half and DN. So, what is left out? AE upon EC. Here, what we have got? Area of triangle ADE upon DBE is equal to AD upon DB. And here it is ADE upon DEC is equals to AE upon EC. Let's write this together. Now, if you notice the left hand side of this and left hand side of this, the numerator is same. Look at the denominator. Denominator is this triangle DEC and triangle DBE. This DBE like this. These are two triangles which are on the same base DE and between the same parallels DE and BC. So there is a theorem. The triangles which are on the same base between the same parallels are equal in area. It means that area of triangle DEC and area of triangle DBE are equal. So we can say area of triangle DEC and area of triangle, these are equal. What reason we are going to write? They lie on the same base. Same base DE, and they lie between the same parallels. Same parallels DE and BC. That is why the areas are equal. Now, when the areas are equal, we can also write it like this. 1 upon area of triangle, I am writing this first. DBE is equal to 1 upon area of triangle DEC. DEC and DBE are equal. So, 1 upon that will also be equal. Now, multiply this by ADE, because our need is like that. This statement, if we will multiply by area of triangle ADE, what will we get? We will get area of ADE upon DEC is equals to area of ADE upon DB. On multiplying it with this ADE, what are we going to get? We will get area of triangle ADE upon area of triangle DBE is equal to area of triangle ADE upon area of triangle DEC. It means that in these two, left hand side is equal, so right hand side will also be equal. So this implies AE upon EC is equal to AD upon DB, or AD upon DB is equal to AE upon EC. That was our need. It means if a line drawn parallel to one of the sides, we'll divide the other two sides in the same ratio. So either you write like this, or this is the proof of basic proportionality theorem or Thales theorem. It was given by the mathematician Thales, which is about the similarity of triangles, or we can say we have applied the concept of parallel lines. That if a parallel line means a line drawn parallel to one of the sides divides the other two sides of a triangle in the same ratio.